roleplay or whatever.
Victor, I'm ready to do business with you, but are you a Bronco fan?
Here we go. I'm sorry. I couldn't hear you, Mr. Diamond. What'd you say?
I said, I'm ready to do this deal with you. My wife likes the house. I like it. I like the everything. Are you a Bronco fan?
Not really. I'm more of a Rams fan, but okay.
If I send you a MAGA hat and a Trump t-shirt, will you keep it clean and wear it to your New Year's Eve party?
I think you already know the answer.
Are you a Republican, a Democrat, a progressive, or a conservative?
I'm a Democratic, progressive, centrist.
Well, me, I'm a hardcore right of Attila the Hun Republican, man. Everything I own is red.
Wow. Okay, well,
what's my
point? I don't know if we're really going to be able to do business, Claude. I mean, you know, we're kind of outside of each other's sort of buy box when it comes to that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you just lost $100,000. You got $100,000 commission, and I asked you. This happens in real life, doesn't it? They just asked you a very personal, political, religious, an inappropriate question.
Oh, got it. Okay, so hold on. I thought you were the salesman, and I was the. Oh, okay. If
we're playing bad, nasty, angry, rude prospect day.
Oh, got it. Okay, got it. Yeah. So I just jumped off, so I missed the whole thing. It's okay. I got it. Okay. Well, Mr. Diamond, I can certainly understand where you are with that, and I'm not one to tell people how to think. You know, if that's how you feel, that's great. But let's get back to the property. How much are you looking to get for it?
Listen, I'm ready to do a deal with you right now. We worked out the numbers. My wife likes you, my dog. I just want to know: Are you a Bronco fan? That's real
important. I can be a Bronco fan.
See, now that's leverage.
Listen, and you guys can disagree with me on this. What happened? Are we supposed to get our ego? We talked about this on Monday. Is sales a place in the negotiation to get our egotistical needs met? Hell no, I'm not a Bronco. I'm a Jets fan. What are you kidding me?
No.
That $100,000 commission.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can be a Bronco fan. All you have to do is just, who's the quarterback anyway? Oh, yeah, I love that guy.
I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
So the answer is, and this is relative, you know, just being very reasonable here, okay? You give that prospect whatever they want. This is not a time to get your emotional, your religious, your political views met. This is only a time to go to the bank.
Got it. Yeah.
This is only a time. Have you guys ever had somebody, you got the sale and then they get very comfortable with you and now you're starting to get into those dangerous little areas?
The money's always green. It's not red or blue.
So what do you, Dave? I like that senator from New York, AOC. I think everybody should be on unemployment right now and get free housing. You feel the same way, don't you, before we do business?
You know, she's got some really good ideas, but
that was good. That was very good. You know, she probably has some good ideas there and everything. I should learn more about it and everything. Did he just dilute the whole thing?
Mm-hmm.
That was perfect.
Yeah.
That was good. Am I the only one who gets sometimes these questions or something that could kill the sale? What happens when
it's our human makeup inside that you get defensive right away if people aren't like-minded, and you can't just blurt that out there. You have to stay in control of the conversation and what the goal is.
Yeah, you get somebody who asks you a black and white and up and down a yes and no question. How do you avoid getting into an argument or a confrontation when you know you've got a sale here?
Once you close escrow, you can go, oh my God, what a schmuck.
When you go to the bank and you cash the check and the deal is done, who wins? You do. You give that prospect within reason whatever they need to make them comfortable enough to do business with you.
Gotta feel like I feel kind of dirty, like a prostitute now. you want the girlfriend experience, or
sales. I call it guts for a reason. Sales is dangerous. Right. If you put your emotional and egotistical needs up front in a business situation, you may feel wonderful about your, you know, what you just said, but are you going to have Mac? Are you going to have a steak on the grill tonight?
Right.
True.
Have you guys seen the price of steak, by the way?
Oh my God.
My carnivores.
Right. Yeah. Right. It's cheaper to eat one at a restaurant than it is to buy one at the store and cook it now.
Right.
It really is.
I went to, Claudia and I were in Costco a couple days ago, and you know, they have the really beautiful meat department and everything. And I was looking at the ribeyes. You get four ribeyes. Man, they caught this one thing of steak cost more than my first car.
Right.
It was amazing. Okay, man. So now, and you can disagree with anything I'm saying today. Okay. My goal is to give you the skills or the right words in the right awkward situation, so that when you get a sale, no matter what, after that prospect goes away, maybe you'll never see him again. You'll never discuss politics or anything else with him. You win. And that's what it's about, isn't it? Oscar, you look like you have a question.
Yeah. I was thinking about another way to answer your question of, are you a Broncos fan? Can you ask me that?
You're a Broncos fan. I only like to do business with people who wear the, blue and orange.
Well, Claude, if I were to say no, does that mean that we couldn't do business?
I'd be very disappointed in you. You're not a Broncos fan?
Well, and then that was my only thing. That was my only addition.
Come on, fix it. Somebody help him fix it. You're not a Broncos fan?
Yeah, the reason I can be a Broncos fan is because now I want him to enroll me in how great the Broncos are, as opposed to shutting it down and saying, oh yeah, no way I can be a Broncos fan or whatever. You know, I want him to now start to convince me about being a Bronco fan and then convince me why I should buy his house.
What did Dave do before? I'm not too much into football, but you know what? Maybe I should be a Bronco. I got to look into it. Who's that great quarterback they have? That guy, that really nice fellow. What's his name again? Help me out.
Mm-hmm. From the Peyton Manning.
Peyton Manning. I've heard great things about him. He really one of the greatest quarterbacks ever?
It goes back to the stroking and nurturing.
Right.
FYI, you don't want to say that Peyton Manning hasn't been their quarterback for years.
I know nothing about
football. Well,
exactly. Issue if you don't know, right?
Yeah.
Don't go there.
But when they won the Super Bowl, he was.
Yeah. So
that's right. Like, that was back when, right?
Right. But what I like what Victor did, and also Dave did, likability and trust. You guys have that likability and trust. And once we develop that with our clients, it's a lot easier to start closing them with that likability and trust. You both did a great job. Even Oscar did a great job too. So.
Yeah. Don't we diffuse this? Can we diffuse the situation? I think it's called a loaded question, right? You're in trouble. Yeah. Yes or no. You know, you're in trouble.
Yeah.
With that question. Can we diffuse it or obfuscate it? One of my favorite little words. Change it a little. Now I've heard great things about that team. Should I learn more about them? Maybe I don't know a lot about that subject, but I think I should learn more about that.
Mm-hmm.
Something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Because you're gonna you meet people. Has anyone here had been to an explosive dinner table, a Thanksgiving dinner?
Every year.